When NVIDIA launched the RTX Super cards a few months ago, they decided to shelf the 2070 and the 2080, replacing them with their respective Super models. But that doesn't mean that the existing stock of these GPUs has run out, which means you might be able to grab yourself a 2080 at a good price. But does it make sense to buy a 2080 right now? Well, let's answer that question by checking out the Colorful RTX 2080. Visually, the Colorful RTX 2080 looks exactly the same as the Colorful RTX 2080 Ti we reviewed a few months ago, sporting the same aggressive armored plating design. The card has three cooling fans, a red highlight core, annular lights, and a backplate spanning across the back of the card. And a high-end card like this wouldn't be complete without RGB options, so you have RGB backlight on the logo as well as the core fan, which you can customize to your heart's extent using the iGame software. It features 2944 CUDA cores, a boost clock speed of 1710 MHz, and 8GB of GDDR6 memory running at 14Gbps. The card is powered by 6+8-pin dual power connectors, and the recommended power supply is 650 watts. For display options, the card provides 3 display ports along with 1 HDMI port and 1 USB Type-C port. When it comes to performance, the Colorful RTX 2080 is pretty damn solid. It can run pretty much every game comfortably at 1440p 60fps or at 1080p if you're looking for higher frame rates, and even provide stable, playable experience with ray tracing turned on. And the fans on this card do an incredible job of keeping the GPU cool, because the maximum GPU temperature we observed during testing was about 68 degrees Celsius. You can also use the iGame software to keep a track of performance metrics like core and memory clock speeds. Now, when the RTX 2080 launched last year, it seemed underwhelming because it was just too expensive for what it offered. Thankfully, that has changed with the coming of the RTX Super lineup, because now you can get the RTX 2080 for just under 50,000 rupees, and that makes all of the difference. The 2070 Super right now is about 44 to 45,000 rupees, and just by spending about 5,000 rupees extra, you can get an easy 10% bump in performance. Sure, you can also get a 2070 Super and overclock it to bridge the gap, but then again, you can overclock the 2080 and get more bang for your buck there too, because the 2080 can do everything that the 2070 Super can, just a little bit better. So, if you can spare some extra money, this is a great deal. If you like this video, be sure to leave a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to TechFix so you can stay updated with all our latest content. Let us know your thoughts in the comments.